music lovers and dear friends of the Major TV, today I will talk about a beautiful composition written by Johann Sebastian Bach, the Canon Super Fa Mi. Stay with us! This beautiful canon was written by Bach in 1749, so there is a lot of secrets. For example, it's an incredible canon written on seven parts on a ground bass. Now, playing it like a concert. Composition is a classical example of harmonic counterpoint, typical of music in Bach. As you know, in music generally, a canon is a contrapuntal compositional technique that employs a melody with one or more imitations of this melody, played after a given duration. In a classic canon, the first voice that you heard, it's dux. It's called with a Latin term. For example, this is a first voice, the dux, and the second voice called the comes. Dux and comes. In this specific case, Bach built a beautiful canon on a ground bass. Italian language, like a basso ostinato. This composition is a classical example of harmonic counterpoint, and I will talk about the elegant and enigmatic design on paper. The contrapuntal compositional technique, it's a canon in unison, at the same voice, at the same interval, with seven voices entering after one bar. And so on. There is a lot of secrets in this canon. For example, the grand bass, it's based on two functions, the tonic, so I play the chord, and the dominant, I play the chord. Harmonic analysis is actually very simple and captivating at the same time. It's a joyfully diatonic canon, based on two chords, the tonic and the dominant. The ground bass is fa la si mi fa la si mi and so on, but on paper it's written fa mi. Why? It's a early remember of medieval practice of solmization, that the rule of solmization was una nota super la sempre scanendo un fa, and so on.
La, fa, mi, fa, la, fa.
written fa mi, et fa mi est tota musica. This diatonic canon, it's based on two functions, the tonic and the dominant, but there is a particular grade of the scale that's ambiguous for its nature. It's a subdominant or a dominant. This canon is an enigmatic canon, because at the end of this composition there is a motto. This motto talk about Faber, like a friend of Bach. Domine possessor, fidelis amici, beatum esse recordari, tibi aut ignotum itaque, bone artis cultorem habeas, veru amicum tuum. Bach. Now, see the solution of seven voice with a ground bass.
And see you later for the next appointment with Bach.